something of cause of the block. Why did the block occur? What is the cause of a block in a coronary heart?
There is no
atherosclerosis. Okay. What is the cause of any thrombus in a child? Hypercoagulable state, hypercholesterolemia, antiphospholipid syndrome, protein C, protein S deficiency. These are the various so inherited hypercoagulable states. So they have a tendency in fact. So these children require to be on long term anticoagulation. They require to be on warfarin.
After liver transplant, what is the long-term prognosis?
As any liver transplant patient, problems of rejection, problems of immunosuppression, but they do very well post-transplant. In fact, in India, we don't do liver transplant. We try for stenting in London. Abroad, if a patient comes like this in London, he would be straight on the transplant.
And in late patient, we cannot do transplant.
We can. That's the only solution.
The possible changes might have occurred in all other veins and all dilated because of the portal hypertension and all.
That gets cured. Portal hypertension is actually the definitive cure.
Late stage also, this is the treatment.
Early stage, you can try stenting and antiplasty. But then they'll repeat it as the child grows. The stent will be smaller. So again, you need to put in a new stent. It's not like an adult that one size stent is enough. So every time the child grows, you need to put in a new stent. Prognosis is, I tell you, infants very bad. I have had 6 patients with birth cheering, all 6 bad. There is no transplant to be done.
Stenting can be done endoscopically?
Through the interventional radiology. So you will have to put it through the jugular into the hepatic vein and stent. So it's not done endoscopically, but it's done through a catheter by the interventional radiologist.
Then how
right side is hard, then how to go? Into the IVC, into the hepatic bone. So that's how
it is done. IVC directly, yeah. Can go from the
bone. From the jugular.
Right anterior to
the IVC.
You can't go from femoral.
Very difficult. This is more straighter route.
Madam, with birth cheering, do they develop anywhere else?
We have one child with portal vein thrombosis, mesenteric vein thrombosis, jugular thrombosis, esophageal thrombosis and much.
What about the other parts like lungs?
They can, anywhere they can. So now this problem got solved of the ascites. Now we come on to the next one. This is a 4-year-old girl. She's got lump in the abdomen since 2 years. We discussed about lump in abdomen in the morning. She's got pallor and intermittent ekymotic patches. There's no jaundice or hematemesis, no blood transfusion, no fever. What is this? So there is a spleen. There is a problem of anemia and there is a problem of the platelet. So what is the problem? Why should IGP have a spleen? ITP should not have a spleen. ITP is bone marrow.
Hyperspleen.
So this is hyperspleen. So spleen is enlarged, destroying platelets, destroying RBC, so this is hyperspleen. So the possible cause here is possible hyperspleen. Right? It's unlikely to be hemolytic. Why is it unlikely to be hemolytic? Because it never required transfusion. Hemolytic anemia, pallor there, would have required transfusion by now. So unlikely to do this. So, probably, now what is the cause of this spleen failure? Why is the child having hypersplenism? Isolated spleen enlarged with hypersplenism.
Recurrent infection
like malaria. There is no history. So she came with a spleen and bluish patches on the body. Can it be that we just incidentally found this spleen? The child did not bleed till now? Can it be portal hypertension?
There is a pancreatic anemia.
Yeah, there is low platelets, low hemoglobin. So most likely pancreatic. So maybe it's an isolated lump, was portal hypertension went into hypersplenism. That is one possibility. Now this child, other is a storage, maybe the spleen of enlarged stored and got it. So that is another. Now this child has no jaundice, no hemolytic patients. Spleenomegaly is up to umbilicus. No liver fat because other systems are not. So isolated spleen with pancreatic hypersplenism. Cause of hypersplenism, maybe portal hypertension, maybe a storage problem. Can it be HIV?
Yes.
Why should HIV cause hypersplenism? HIV will cause reticuloendothelial system affection. Right? So that part of the, that is the reason why the spleen is there. But it does not, the spleen is functioning properly. So it should not cause hypersplenism. Hypersplenism occurs when the spleen has to overfunction. So we have to go back to school. Yeah, one is tropical splenomegaly. It has been diagnosed. Nothing we get, we label the child as tropical splenomegaly. So we need to do, we still don't know what it is, right? So we need to do CBC reflecting. We need to do a peripheral smear to look for hemolytic anemia. We need to look at the liver, whether actually we are not palpating a liver, but is it a cirrhotic liver? So that is one thing that we need to check. Now we all have seen hemoglobin is 3.4. Why should there be cirrhosis? Now this child has a lump.
Yeah.
Spleen. So can it be a
past history of jaundice or something?
Not necessarily. Maybe cryptogenic cirrhosis will cause hypertension. So if you are not factable, does not mean there is no liver problem. Still you are LFT. Rule out there is no liver problem. WBC count is okay, not that bad. So he is not leukopenic. Platelets are 19,000. So two cell lines are low. Platelet count is borderline, 2.7. Neither I, neither low. Electrophoresis was done because somebody thought this is hemolytic anemia, which is normal. LFT is normal, bilirubin normal, SGLT, everything normal. And then osmotic fragility is normal. Somebody also thought of hereditary spherocytosis. Everything is normal. Except the
pancytopenia.
Tropical splenomegaly. But did I rule out portal hypertension there? I am not ruled out for that. So I need to rule that out. Now what do I do next? I have to do USG abdomen. It's showing splenomegaly with portal cavernoma. So this child has never bled. He straight away went into hypersplenism. So this is extrahepatic portal hypertension. There is no liver problem. So most likely there is a thrombus which form collapses. That's why the cavernoma developed. So isolated lump can be portal hypertension. So not tropical splenomegaly.
Explain me my
diagnosis.
I said
charisma
major at that point.
Charisma major without blood transfusion.
No. Child is already born and after some time we find the spleen enlarged. It has happened to me, that's why I'm talking.
Yeah, but this child is a bigger child.
4 years. 4 years.
Fine.
4 years thalassemia major or not? They will come to you 6-7 months when the fetal hemoglobin starts going away.
Yeah.
And they will decompensate at that time. They will come to you as liver or spleen isolated and anemia. They will again not come to you as thrombocytopenia. They will not come to you as hypersplenism. Hypersplenism occurs when transfusion requirement is not going properly. The spleen has to do extramedullary hematopoiesis. Spleen enlarges because of that and then it's hyperfunction. So hypersplenism is not seen until the child of thalassemia is 12 years, 10 years, then you develop.
Madam, in storage disorder in HIV, there won't be any hypersplenism?
No.
Both the conditions?
It's not a storage.
Storage again, there could be hypersplenism.
Storage will have a hypersplenism number of years. Because normal tissue has got replaced by abnormal tissue. So spleen has to overcome. Whereas HIV is radically endothelial cells, the HIV virus went inside. So it caused splenomegaly, but otherwise it did not cause functional problem.
Storage can be a function.
Yes. So our diagnosis was extrahepatic portal hypertension. Again was sleeping. Now I think everyone wide awake. So how would you manage such a case? Why do you want to vaccinate it?
Before acting, so
the
next coming, before
the next coming, you go for the vaccine, take vaccine. He may become trans, he may require transfusion, he may have mother with this one, but I do be vaccinated too. So, how do you manage this photo?
And that's
what
we're
doing. One is medical line of management. We are all medical people, physicians. We don't like to send our patients to surgery. Right? So we want to manage them. So we give them drugs that will decrease the portal pressure. So, propranolol.